Everybody, we are back, you're back, welcome to our second class, and I hope you're doing great, you have a lot of energy for today. Okay, so let's see, let's jump into today's class. As usual, we read our objective. Today we have only one. Okay, you will be able to recognize writing strategies and apply them in an essay. Okay, apply them in an essay. Reconocer estrategias de lectura y aplicarlas en un essay. What is essay? That's a good question. What is an essay? An essay is an organized piece of writing that focuses on a single topic. It is organized around a general idea or thesis. Okay? Es un, digamos que un extracto de una escritura, algo organizado, okay, una pieza de escritura organizada que se enfoca en un tema, solamente en un tema, okay, y está organizada a partir de una idea general o una tesis. Essay, en español, ensayo, okay. So let's talk about this. Let's talk about the essays. So, the essay needs three elements. The introduction or thesis statement, okay, they are synonym, supporting ideas or argument, and on the third place, we need the conclusion, okay? So, let's see. Thesis statement. What is thesis statement? A sentence that says what the author wants his reader to know, believe, and understand about a subject. Okay, the thesis statement, esa es una oración que el autor quiere que el lector sepa, conozca, entienda acerca del tema en cuestión. Thesis statement también puede ser fácilmente la introducción del ensayo. Okay? Supporting ideas. This is the second element, right? Segundo elemento. Supporting ideas, we can find examples, statistics, opinion, facts, and personal observation and experiences. Son esas ideas que soportan, que ideas secundarias, ¿sí? Argumentos que le dan más credibilidad al ensayo, ¿ok? Ejemplos, estadísticas, opiniones, hechos y también opiniones personales, ¿ok? So, how to organize supporting ideas? To organize supporting ideas successfully, take a look at this, we are going to use connectors. Connectors, but we are going to focus on sequence connectors. For example, first of all, secondly, the third point, and in summary. Entonces, para organizar las ideas secundarias, pues necesito hacer uso de conectores. Y los conectores que vamos a estudiar el día de hoy son los conectores de secuencia, los que uso para un ensayo. Tenemos unos ejemplos allí. And there are a lot of examples, actually. Okay, as you can see, here we have an extensive list of connectors of sequence. First, second, third, finally, next, meanwhile, after, before, later, then, subsequently, and I can continue, okay? Porque tenemos una lista larga de conectores. Sin embargo, hay unos que son más populares que otros, que son más usados y que también estoy seguro de que ustedes han visto antes. Yeah? Then we have the conclusion. And the conclusion, what is the conclusion? The conclusion is the final paragraph of the essay. Okay, these phrases are used for the conclusion. In summary, in conclusion, okay? Bueno, cuando ustedes vean estas frases, in summary or in conclusion, ya ustedes saben que aquí viene la conclusión del ensayo en cuestión. Okay? So, as homework, guys, you have to look up the meaning of these different connectors, these connectors of sequence, okay? We have first, second, third, First of all, second of all, secondly, in summary, in conclusion, to sum up and to summarize. Como deber, pues, debemos buscar el significado de estos conectores. Algunos ya lo sabemos. ¿Y dónde lo vamos a buscar? Pues puede ser en un diccionario que tengamos en casa, en un diccionario digital, que es lo recomendado para hacer esto. O también, en último lugar, podemos usar el traductor también, ¿ok? So, look up the meaning of the words, guys. Make a summary about the video. Make a summary, ¿ok? Hacer un resumen de este video también, como segunda actividad. And that's all. Two short activities. We finished today's class, guys. I hope you understood. If you have any questions, let me know, as usual, ok? Have a great weekend.